Welcome to the Columbia Icefield on the North Campus of the University of Waterloo for tonight's OUA men's hockey matchup between the visiting Guelph Gryphons and the Waterloo Warriors. My name is Adam McGuire, and with me is Dan Ackerman. And Dan, the turkey's been eaten, the new year has been rung in, so that means...
That's right, this is when the OUA West starts to divide themselves and you separate the best teams from the good teams. And they've been off a month here, so let's see... With Waterloo only playing one exhibition game in that Christmas break, so they'll be looking to get the kinks out early in this first period. And Guelph and Waterloo battled to a 5-4 game earlier in the season, October 15th. So expect a hard-fought, hard-checking battle once again between these two teams, the Gryphons and the Warriors.
Away we go. Off the opening faceoff, that's Martin for the Gryphons, hammered in there by Vasey. Mike Vasey for the Warriors. Back to retrieve it is Priamo. To his defense partner, that's Nathan Martin. Martin slows it down through the neutral zone. The Guelph captain, that was Bellin. He is hammered off the puck. Lewicki and Vasey in right away with Shepard on a forechecking line. Puck cleared in to Keaton Hartigan, the starting goaltender for the Waterloo Warriors. This is Hartigan. Starting for the Guelph Gryphons is Andrew Loverock. Loverock gets his first action. He steers that long dump in aside from Vasey. Shepard in on the forecheck. Bellin muscles him off the puck. Cycles it behind the net to Priamo. Tim Priamo, his long pass just missed Thomas Kiriakou, and icing is the call.
You mentioned Andrew Loverock getting his first action in CIS hockey, and coming from the Sudbury Wolves, is it, of the OHL?
Spent the last 2.5 years with Sudbury. Last year played 41 games with the Wolves.
Okay.
Was their starter for the bulk of the of OHL action.
Big
see
guy.
How he fares.
Got a 6'3 in that there.
I think we expected to see Cody St. Jacques, who we saw here for the Warriors' home opener in that 5-4 loss. But St. Jacques not even dressed as the backup tonight. The backup is Scott Van Bommel. Over the bench, over the boards, into the bench and out of play for another whistle. Just over a minute in. Guelph and Waterloo bunched together a little bit in the standings. Waterloo in fourth place in the OUA West right now. Guelph in sixth, and Waterloo actually had an excellent stretch. Just before the holiday break, they had a six-game winning streak that was snapped just before the break ended in a road game against the Brock Badgers. Face-off scrambled, and Ryan Molly plays that one in. Back in the net and spinning off a check there is Patrick Campbell. He did move the puck before he was hammered, though. And Peroff cycles it back to Campbell. Campbell and Peroff play catch behind the bench, behind the net with it. Through the neutral zone, McDonald tapped that one in for the Gryphons. And Kyle Sonnenberg, Waterloo's quarterback on the power play from the back end. Their leading scorer among defensemen. Now Chris Ray, the captain and the leading point getter of all Warriors. His shot was wide of the net. Schwendy and Moyer battle in the corner. Puck comes to Ray. Campbell muscles him to the boards. Schwendy keeps it alive momentarily, and Ray on the backhand. Back into Moyer behind the net. Moyer fends off a man. Spins away from another check. Tries to center it back to the blue line. It's Molly. Waits. Tries to play it to Sonnenberg. It was too wide for him. Sonnenberg keeps it in momentarily, but the puck out and into the neutral zone. Sonnenberg turns with it right away. Trying to catch Guelph on a change. They weren't able to actually make a change. Sonnenberg made a nice move, and now the puck kept in by Ray. Along the sideboards, Ray. His pass back to the point. Molly. Able to slow it up, almost an odd man rush there for the Gryphons. Even long, his long lead pass, here's Ray. He's got a step, Ray in. His weak shot stopped and held. Peroff caught him and put a stick on him just before he could get a shot away. And the puck was stopped and covered up by Andrew Loverock.
Yeah, great play, by heads-up play by Keelan Wong to get that up to a springing Chris Ray, who was driving hard down to the zone. And got a weak shot away as the Guelph defender came back and got a stick on the puck to... slow down that shot and make it an easy save for Loverock.
James Merritt, he carries the puck out. No icing. Icing waved off, much to the dismay of Keaton Hartigan. To the neutral zone now, Kurt Thorner taps it in, but retrieving it is Mark Pulowski for the Gryphons. Turned over in the Gryphon zone there, and Hill rings it all the way around. To the line, not out. Slammed back into the far corner by Aaron Dilio. And we'll have our first penalty of the game. Looks like it'll be a slash, and it looks like it'll be against the Gryphons.
Yeah, I expect a penalty filled affair here tonight. The two teams jawing at each other before the game at center ice, and I think this is going to be a heated game, and it's a heated rival between these two teams only half hour away, and when they get together, it's always a close, hard-fought battle, and we won't expect any different tonight.
Zach Lilly is the culprit. He goes to the penalty box for a slash, and you're right, we did see a little bit of temperate stick swinging and jawing back and forth in the warm-ups at center ice.
Just some gamemanship.
some pucks being fired back and forth across the red line. So on the power play, the Warriors, this is Ray to Whiteley, who was involved in the skirmish at center ice. Around the boards, Ray couldn't reach it to keep it in, so back to the neutral zone it comes, and it's Kyle Sonnenberg. He will take his time in his own zone. His pass too hot to handle there for Schwendi, and back the other way shorthanded is Majera. Shot right in front, tipped. Bellin made a play towards the net, and the left leg of Keaton Hardigan kept that one out. Very good save there. Now a shorthanded two-on-one chance here. Majera, Campbell catching up. Majera in front of the net. Campbell couldn't slap that one home, and he went crashing into Hardigan. Two shorthanded chances now for the Gryphons. Moyer spins at the blue line, backhands it into the far corner. Paradine, he can't keep it in. The puck bounces over his stick. Regroups in his own zone and plays it up ahead. Now in for Jarrett Schnurr. Schnurr for the Warriors. His pass all the way back and into the neutral zone. Carradine has to recover that one himself. The Waterloo power play looking a little unorganized early on. Only 20 seconds left in the man advantage. Carradine, he's got some room now in front of the net. Big save by Lovrock. Schnurr and Thorner were both in there. I didn't see who got the shot, but it was a solid shot across on the cross ice feed, and Lovrock came across and made a nice stop.
I think that was Kurt Hill who had the chance, and just couldn't find the hole between Lovrock. You mentioned it, made a big save coming from his left, from his right to his left.
Elvasian on the forecheck. Kiriakou takes the puck from him to the line and out. Puck went over the glass and out of play, but nobody saw it. It bounced off the netting. Now the other way come the Gryphons. A shot stopped and held there by Hardigan. And Aaron Dilio exchanges shoves.
Up to his usual shenanigans, as always. But the Warriors not being that organized on that penalty to start with. 14 seconds left in the power play was their best chance. But Guelph got the best two chances shorthanded, with Campbell going hard in the net. And Hardigan getting tested his first shot of the game, having to make a very heads-up pad save with the left pad to keep this game locked at zero. And Waterloo will have to get that power play organized the next time around, as it looked quite disorganized and people standing still in the neutral zone when they were trying to move into the glove zone.
Definitely the people, some forwards standing still waiting for the pass, didn't do anything with it once they reached it, though, because they were standing still. First period has been a trouble for the Warriors. Lyle's sharp angle shot went high and wide. Warriors have given up 3 goals in, I believe it's 4 first periods this year. Some more words after the whistle. I think the officiating crew is probably going to have to send a message early.
Yeah, it'll be a busy night for them. It's always a heated affair between these two.
A little pent-up frustration from the holidays, maybe. Face off to the left of Keaton Hardigan. Off the draw, the puck skips harmlessly towards the net, cleared away and into the neutral zone. Shot right back in by the Gryphons. Priamo hammered that one into the corner. And back to the neutral zone, it's Martin. Lead pass to Alex Majera. Out to play it is Hardigan. Hardigan, bounce pass off the end boards. Starts the breakout for the Warriors. That's McDonald. Al McDonald backhands it into the zone. Fraser is first there on the forecheck, and Cardiff. This is one of the Warriors' top energy lines. You're not going to see a ton of offense from them, but I think the point is to get in on the forecheck, lay some physicality on the opposition. Keelan Wong slides it the other way. Frazier off the boards and out. And the Warriors go for a change. Nathan Martin, also involved in the hijinks early on in the warm-up. Tipped in again by Kinsella. Sonnenberg's the first one there. He's got a man on him, that's Kusi. Sonnenberg clears it out, though, and through the neutral zone and into the Guelph end come the Warriors. Moyer, he couldn't find anybody in front. Schwendy is the first one of the puck. Spins away from a check there. In front of the net now. Sonnenberg pinches in. Puck up and over the boards and out of play.
Well, some key players for the Warriors, as always, Chris Ray and Kyle Sonnenberg. You mentioned Sonnenberg on the power play being the quarterback throughout the game, and especially on the power play, and Ray having a sensational year. If it wasn't for that injury, he'd probably be atop the leaderboard, but he has notched at least a point in every game he's played, every league game this year for the Warriors, and look for him to keep that trend continuing and to be a key player here if Waterloo is going to steer the ship in the right direction in the second half of the 2010-11 season.
Absolutely. Key for the Warriors. Both of those players actually will be missing a couple of league games as they play the World University Games, both making Team Canada. The OUA is representing Canada this year. We'll be going to Turkey, I believe.
Yeah, that's right.
The end of January, early February. Thomas Kiriakou for the Gryphons will also be on that team. Now Campbell in over the line. Backhanded Kiriakou through the crease. Nobody was there to finish it. Bellin, he can't keep the puck in, and Schnurr just tips it up and out. Now in his own zone, it's Chris Bielan. Turns it over. Basie now tries to feed it ahead for Schappert, and the Warriors had a bit of a two-on-one there, but no speed as the hit from Basie knocked him still. Couldn't get a good shot away. It looks like the Warriors' game plan will be to put the forecheck on heavily. Now a long lead pass. Vasey tries to make a move. Can't keep control of Lewicki. He spins out into the corner. Schappert battles there. Cycles it with Lewicki to Schappert. His shot blocked. Another one. He couldn't reach it. Whiteley pinches up. His long shot in from the point. Lewicki keeps it in. He'll take a shot. Schappert tried to tip it just wide, but it looks like Schappert will get a penalty.
Yeah,
for goaltender interference.
Looked to me like Loverock was out of his crease, but he may have been just on top of the blue paint, and Schappert getting a little overzealous on that one, and the appropriate call is Schappert to go off sit at two or less.
It's also a tough call for the officials. I know some officials actually don't even adhere to the crease as kind of a point of reference for that call. If the goaltender has a chance to make a save is impeded, no matter where he is on the ice, they'll make that call.
In that case, good call. Puck was on net. Schappert had a chance to slow up, and he continued, and Loverock was impeded on his chance to make the save, and appropriate call, and Guelph goes to their first power play of this young game.
Well, actually, it looks like it'll be an even-up call. Barrett Brook took a shot.
My apologies.
At Schappert after the whistle. I didn't see that call either, but the ref has called roughing on Brook and goaltender interference on Schappert, so offsetting minor penalties. Schappert had his helmet ripped off. In front of the net now, a chance. Martin pinches up from the point. The puck was lying in the crease, and McFarland couldn't get a shot away. Now a long shot, Martin, wrister, and now the Warriors will be penalized, it looks like, and Guelph will go to their first power play. As that shot came in low to Keaton Hartigan, looked like Ryan Molly got his stick in between the legs of a Guelph attacker, and he'll take a tripping penalty.
Well, a good first 10 minutes here for Waterloo, especially after a month off. They've come out flying, come out hitting hard, and as you mentioned, the forecheck has been a key for them early on, and they'll have to make a big play here to kill off this two-minute penalty power play for the Gryphons.
Martin hammered one off the faceoff. to the short side. It was kicked away by Hartigan. Hartigan looks sharp. Not a lot of rust on him, it would appear. And cleared down the ice by the Warriors. Loverock will set it up for Nathan Martin. Martin ahead to Ed Gale. Gale now, his long shot, low and wide, kept in. Martin with it now. Martin looks for a shooting lane, blocked there by Chris Ray. You'll see Ray in pretty much every scenario for the Warriors. Yep. Penalty kill, power play, even strength. He'll even likely take a double shift or two at center ice should the game situation render it. Long pass to Gale, streaking on the wing again. Off the boards, but not out. Fraser tries to clear, kept in there by Bellin. Martin, he's been on for the entire first minute of this power play. Priamo can't keep that one in. Just about a break there for Cardiff. Couldn't knock it past. Priamo, second effort, kept that one into the neutral zone. Now Priamo gains the line. Tries to send it to Kiriakou. Whiteley was there first. Rung around to the line and out. Loverock will set it up again for the Gryphons. Pair off to Matt Lyle. Kyle McDonald hammered him off the puck, slammed it back towards the Guelph end. That one shot in by Patrick Campbell. Whiteley, he lays a body on a man. Puck hit the official, kept in at the line now. Pair off his shot, stopped, and the rebound is gobbled up and held by Keaton Hartigan. 14 seconds remaining in the Guelph power play.
Good job of Waterloo killing off this penalty, showing in their speed. McDonald, Ray getting their sticks in the lane and making big pass interceptions and getting it down and killing time off this penalty. And really the only good chance was that point shot by Peroff, and an easy save for Hartigan.
Face off to the right of Hartigan. To the line, Peroff. A big blast. That one was blocked. Fraser stopped that one. And two Gryphons are behind the play on the ice. And I don't know what happened, but it was enough for another Warrior power play, or a penalty, excuse me. It'll be Aaron Dilio, an interference call. So a two-man advantage for the Gryphons with nine seconds, and then right back to the power play for the road team. Didn't see what happened off the draw, but it spilled two Gryphons, and it was enough to draw attention to the officials to make the call.
Yeah,
Ray, who is the best Warrior face-off man, excuse me, Dan.
That's right.
Take it. Ray did win the face-off, but the puck wasn't cleared. Bellin back to Martin. Thorner is out. Shot blocked from the point. Kept in again by Martin to Kiriakou. Kiriakou, he tried to pass across the ice. Ray intercepted that. Puck bounced down into the corner to Gale. Gale had his pocket picked by Ray again. Ray chips it off the boards and out. Yeoman's working the penalty kill by the captain, Chris Ray. Kiriakou to an open wing. Thorner was the first to reach that. Now Cowardine with some time off the glass, up and out, and cleared all the way down again by the Warriors. So the penalty killing thus far for the Warriors, and the Gryphon power play looking perhaps as unorganized as the Waterloo one did early on.
That's right, and a big block by Sonnenberg when they had the two-man advantage, enabling them to get their... that man back on and beat it down to a 5-on-4, and they're doing a great job here on killing off this penalty, and Hartigan continues to stand tall.
Hartigan took the sharp angle shot away from Matt Lyle, covered up the rebound. Hartigan looks extremely comfortable, made a couple of difficult saves,
yeah,
as has his counterpart Andrew Loverock, in all fairness.
That's right, Loverock has been stellar back there too. He's made some pretty key saves to keep this game at zero.
Face-off kept in. Era, long shot off the blocker hand and out of play. Hartigan made that save. A bit of an OUA tradition to alternate colored and white jerseys from home and away at the Christmas break. So from here on in, the Warriors at home will be in the whites.
Making it a little bit easier on your eyes.
No comment. Lewicki behind the net. McDonald trapped the puck there with him. There's four players, two from each squad behind the net. Lewicki trying to fight it, and it comes to Chris Ray. Ray has some time. 30 seconds left. He'll rag the puck back to Cowardine, and a long lead pass to Ray. Ray content to play catch back to Whiteley in his own zone.
Just a veteran play by Chris Ray. He knows The puck is uncanny, and he knows what he's doing out there to kill his penalty, and kills about 40 seconds there to get the penalty power play down to the...
And tips that one past Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg keeps him to the outside. Chris Bellin back to Campbell. Patrick Campbell keeps it into the line. Down low to Gale. Gale with a step, a shot, stopped. The rebound in front of the net. They score! Just as the penalty had expired, the Gryphons get on the board first. The loose puck bounced to the right. I believe it was Kiriakou there that tapped it home. So Thomas Kiriakou, who already leads the Gryphons in points, adds another one to his tally, and it's 1-0 Guelph.
Yeah, just putting pucks on net there with the final seconds in the power play was the key for the Gryphons. And the puck happened to go off a Warrior shin pad defender and slide over to Kiriakou. And he fanned on the shot, but it was able to creep his way past a diving Hardigan and across the goal line to put the Gryphons up 1-0 with 6 minutes remaining in the first period.
Dumped in, Hardigan almost played that, but it was icing. So the scoring play is Kiriakou from Bellin and Gale. The Warriors try to answer. Schappert spins and fires off a shin pad and wide. Moyer in on the forecheck with Schappert. Trying to jar the puck loose. Spins away from the check of Pulowski. Back to Wong. He fans on the wrist shot. Tipped by him. But back to help him recover is Dilio. Now a chance. A big move there. A beautiful move by Zach Lilly and his wrist shot. Low to the side of the blocker side of Keaton Hardigan is stopped. Lilly made a dynamite move there to step around a defenseman. Schwendi, his dump in was blocked. Pulowski turns him away. And again, cycle back. The Warriors caught on a bit of a change. Majera's shot just wide. Zach Lilly, Majera went crashing in after that shot to the net. Knocked the net off its moorings.
Yeah, that faceoff's going to come outside, I think. Made no attempt to stop sliding into the net.
Faceoff is outside the zone.
Outside.
Wimon leans in to take it against Hill. Nathan Martin smacks it into the Warrior zone. Cowardine is there. Now Kurt Hill over the line. Throws it into the corner. First one there is Kurt Thorner. Thorner and Hill. Couldn't keep it in. And puck skipped over Kusi's stick. Right back to Hill. Hill tosses it in from just over center ice. Thorner now. The centering pass off of the side of the net. And a defender and over the glass and out of play. Looks like this faceoff will stay inside.
Yeah, I think they're saying it went off Lovrock. Or not.
Now they're moving it outside of the zone.
And it did go off the goalie and the faceoff will come outside.
So 4:53 remaining in the first period. It's 1-0 Gryphons. Neutral zone faceoff won by the Warriors. And Kyle Sonnenberg throws that into the far corner. Tim Priamo flips it high into the neutral zone but gives it right back to the Warriors. Martin, who seems to have played it about 11 minutes already, is it? If I had to guess, I'm sure that's high, but hasn't left the ice much.
No, he's been on quite a bit, and he's a solid defender back there. Stay-at-home defense, and tough one to get around. He's quick.
Quick and moves the puck well for a stay-at-home defenseman, as you mentioned. Still could chip in with the offense as well.
Yeah, that's right.
Neutral zone turnover now, and Basie for the Warriors. His pass bounces off a stick right to Lewicki. Lewicki centers it in front. Schappert couldn't get a stick on that to the line, but Kinsella will be there and skate it out for the Gryphons. He'll dump it in and go out for a change. Ellen lays a hit on Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg a little slow skating away from that hit. He'll go to the bench. Bouncing puck right down in on Lovrock. We'll close the wickets and hold for a faceoff with 3:47 remaining in the first period.
You mentioned the Warriors have struggled during this first period, and especially in 2010 and early on in the season. And if you're Brian Burke, there's no panic. Just reel the boys in and keep forechecking, and you'll get one eventually.
Quick sharp angle shot from Ray. It was almost there. Loverock didn't see it. Just bounced off his left pad and behind the net. Now Chris Bellin the other way for the Gryphons. Bellin holds and waits, fires wrist shot wide. Puck bounces behind the net. Griffin bench thought it was in.
It was kind of a disappearing puck there for a sec. I think it got stuck up in the equipment of Whiteley and eventually fell down just behind the net, behind Hartigan.
Kiriakou to the open wing. Moyer turns it back the other way for the Warriors. Shot in high and knocked down by Ken Perroff. Perroff to Jeffries. Kiriakou couldn't find that puck. He turned the wrong way. And the Warriors throw it right back in. Perroff now protects the puck behind his own net. Breakout pass to McDonald. Too hot for him to handle, but Lyle will skate it away. Thomas Cardiff behind the net for the Warriors. To Fraser, chips it up and out. High shoot and knocked down by Hartigan. The Warriors will try the breakout one more time. Through the center of the ice, that's Sonnenberg. Lyle picked off that pass. The Griffins doing a very good job plugging up the neutral zone. Not a traditional trap, though. They're sending more than one forechecker in for sure. They're not setting up shop in the neutral zone. They're just heavy forecheck and active sticks are peeling the pucks away from the Warriors. Big shot now from the point. Tipped in front. It's under Hartigan. He will hold for a whistle.
Yeah, he had no clue it was under him. He was looking around, and fortunately it did get buried in his pads. But you mentioned that that unorthodox neutral zone trap is working for the Griffins as they pressure two down and keep the stick active and creating quite a few offensive chances from it and almost going up by two goals there.
Very different from the passive 1-2-2.
That's right.
Forechecking approach we've seen in the past by other teams. Basically putting four men on each of the neutral zone faceoff dots. Puck over the glass and out of play. 2 minutes exactly remaining in the first period. Again, it's 1-0 Guelph on the Thomas Kiriakou marker, just as a Griffin power play had expired. Warriors came out looking at the better of the two clubs, but as the period has worn on, I think Hartigan's been the busier of the two netminders.
Yeah, those two or three back-to-back penalties by the Warriors definitely gave the Griffins the momentum.
Jarrett Schnurr, he'll skate it out of his own zone and hit Kurt Thorner. 3-on-2 for the Warriors now. Hill, backhander, puck high over the crossbar. Puck knocked off the moorings, and some more pushing and shoving after the whistle. Looked like Nathan Martin knocked that puck off. Martin and Dilio. Martin came right over to Dilio. I don't know if there's any real reason that he did other than to cause some trouble.
That's Dilio's trouble is his glove away. It's like kindergarten a little bit here as they play. They try to do it as the ref's not looking, and then as soon as he looks, they smarten up, but not sure what the penalty's here. We'll get that sorted out and let you know in a second.
It'll likely be an even-up call, I would imagine.
Looks as if it's going to be coincidental roughing penalties and nothing else.
Lily and Schnurr in the box, the respective clubs. This game's probably going to get messier before it gets cleaner.
Yeah, it's only the first period, and they're jawing at each other quite a bit here. And as you mentioned, it is only the first period with a minute 42 remaining. We're in for a penalty-filled, I think it's going to be the parade to the box here, as you've already seen on the first period.
Whiteley leaves it for Sonnenberg in his own zone. Back to Whiteley. Longley pass to Ray. One touch to the wing. Schwendy shot off a shin pad and wide. High skill play there by Ray. Now a pass in front, tipped. Whiteley, the shovel pass, was tipped right on there by Ray, and it was stopped by Loverock. Now a spin move tried there by McDonald, I believe, from the Gryphons. Excuse me, that was Majera. He'll get the puck back and can't do anything with it. And it'll just be shot in by James Merritt. Long pass now for Tyler Moyer, first-year Warrior. Under a minute now to play in the first period. Now Cousy. Michael Cousy. Puck knocked off his stick. Lewicki tried to send it back to Cowardine. Cowardine reaches for it and taps it to the neutral zone. Now Kiriakou's pass. Cousy was still trapped inside the zone, so nobody could retrieve it for the Gryphons, and the Warriors will have a chance to set up a breakout. Now we see a little more traditional 1-2-2 pass of forecheck from the Gryphons. Puck shot in, icing waved off. Pulowski is the first one there. He maintains position and keeps Shepard away from the loose puck, and now Kiriakou with some speed. On the right wing, Kiriakou in front of the net. Kinsella couldn't battle his way with a loose puck in front. Now Cowardine turns the other way. 4 seconds remaining in the period. Shepard going wide, can't get a shot away. His weak attempt towards the net will slide into the corner as the period expires. So after one, it'll be 1-0. It looks like the officials at each bench would like to have a word with the coaching staffs.
Yeah, good for good reason. I think they just want to make sure the coaches deliver the message. Calm down here, boys. A lot of game left, and we don't want to get don't want anyone hurt here. We don't want any blood on the ice, so let's try to keep it clean for the remaining 40 minutes. Smart move by the official.
Officials telling Gryphons head coach Sean Camp and Warriors head coach Brian Burke to stick around on the bench for a moment so we can have a word.
And Brian Burke is mic'd tonight. We're going to see if we get a wired feature of Brian Burke. Warrior Digital, so it'll be interesting to see if we catch what the official had to say with Brian Burke, and I'm sure we can guess what he's saying.
Absolutely. So we'll take a break here to resurface the ice, and we'll take a break up here as well. After one period, it's the Warriors trailing the Guelph Gryphons 1-0. Welcome back to the Columbia Icefield on the north campus of the University of Waterloo after one period. The Guelph Gryphons lead the Waterloo Warriors 1-0 on a goal by Thomas Kiriakou. Before we get going for the second period here in Waterloo, though, let's take a look at the OUA out-of-town scoreboard. Earlier on today, Nipissing taking it to the Ryerson Rams, 7-3, the final in that game. Game's still going on right now. Midway through the second period, McGill, a little bit of a surprise here, only up 2-1 on the Ottawa Gigis. McGill, one of the top teams in the country, haven't lost in regulation yet this season, only two shootout overtime losses, both to OUA West teams during the conference crossover play before the holidays. RMC up on Toronto 3-1 midway through the second period as well. After one in Thunder Bay, Lakehead leads the Windsor Lancers 1-0. The start of the second period, York and UOIT still tied with no score. Same score for the Laurier Golden Hawks in London to face the Western Mustangs, another team that hasn't lost in regulation yet this season. No score after one period of play. Here are the score. Once again, Guelph leading 1-0 over Waterloo. SSNCanada.ca. Dan, a chippy first period to say the least, and I think that the officials were really trying to get a bit of a hold on this game before it got out of hand.
Yeah, that's right. We saw it right off the bat. We mentioned it earlier. They're chirping at each other in the warm-up with Whiteley and Campbell on the other side, and we knew it was going to be a heated affair, but didn't think it was going to be the parade that we saw to the box, and had about four penalties aside, and the refs wanted to have a gym between periods to their guys in the dressing room saying, look guys, let's calm down. I know we dislike each other, but let's make sure no one gets hurt out here, and we'll see what happens here, but it's going to be, once again, a physical affair, and we don't expect anything less between these two rivals, only 30 minutes down the road from each other, and they see each other three or four times a year, and have seen each other once already with a 5-4 decision going to the Waterloo Warriors in regulation, so we expect hard physical game, but I think the officials is just trying to get a hold of this game before it got out of hand.
Yes, indeed. Shots after one period. Guelph 16, Waterloo 9. We mentioned the Warriors came out probably the hotter of the two teams right out of the gate.
Yep. But
the Gryphons certainly in the last 10 to 12 minutes of that first period had the bulk of the chances and the shots on goal reflected that. Keaton Hartigan has played well. And again, the only goal by Thomas Kiriakou, not on the power play, but for all intents and purposes, still a man advantage. The penalty had just expired and the man had not gotten back into the play. It was a bit of a scrum in front of the net. Kiriakou didn't get good wood on the shot, but got enough to get it over the line. So the Warriors find themselves down a goal heading into the second period. Getting set to go. Some
ice repairs
right outside the blue line.
And I think if you're Brian Burke, you're just settling the boys down. Like, look, guys, stop taking dumb penalties. Gryphons have showed their power play, especially the last two power plays. They have the presence of their captain, number 43, Bellin, who just stands in front of the net and plays as a shield so Hartigan can't see the pucks. And I think Burke just tells the boys, look, let's just do what we did right in the first 10 minutes of this game. What got us chances, and that was the forecheck and moving our legs and just cycling that puck down low once they get possession, and we'll see if the Waterloo Warriors can even this score up in the second period.
Warriors start with the Lewicki Shepherd Vasey line. Right away it's Lewicki and Shepherd trying to jar the puck loose behind the net. Kiriakou is back there with Martin, and the Gryphons clear it down to center ice. Played there by Colin Cowardine. Steve Whiteley, he gives the puck away. Bellin now, 3-on-2 down low. Pass in front. Bellin, it was behind him, couldn't reach it. Now a 2-on-2 the other way. Vasey with a step on a defenseman. He takes Martin into the boards. Martin looked at the official waiting for the arm to go up and didn't see it. In front of the net, Vasey in the prone position. Tried to get the stick on that one. It was a great play by Vasey even to become a threat on that chance.
Yeah.
Laying flat on his belly, did get a shot away. Love Rock was there.
Yeah, good job of Love Rock coming across there. You mentioned Lewicki did have that chance, but was on his knees. Sorry, Vasey was on his knees, but unable to get any wood on the stick, and Love Rock came across and made a big save.
Face off to the right of Love Rock. Won by the Gryphons. Patrick Campbell to the line. Kept in there by Sonnenberg. Up along the boards. Still hammered back in just onside. But now clear to the neutral zone, and it's McDonald. Now the puck back into the Griffin zone. That's Campbell. He's taking it hard there. Almost Cardiff with a hit. Sonnenberg now stepped into that one from the point. That one was a high. And all the way out off the live boards and down the ice to the Warriors zone comes the loose puck. Ryan Molly is there. High off the glass. Long pass to Ray. Ray cuts to the center of the ice, protects the puck. Lyle knocks him off of it. Ray still battling with it. Fighting for the puck with three Gryphons. Finally, Guelph comes away with it, and a 3-on-2 develops through the neutral zone. Schwendi, comes back to make it an even 3-on-3. Oh, a shot from the line. That one was blocked. Moyer took his time clearing it out. Play is called. Molly knocked the puck down with his glove, but took a step or two with it.
Yeah, I seemed to freeze there. I didn't know what to do, whether to move it up or couldn't find an open man, but took a little too long, and Guelph was on him in a hurry, and with a nice forecheck and created a chance out of it.
It was not enough for a penalty.
No.
Closing his hand on the puck, but enough. I think the referee gave him the benefit of the doubt that it maybe got caught up in his equipment. There's a wrist shot from the point that's tipped high over the glass and out of play.
Saw a nice chance by Chris Ray for a minute before that, cutting into the middle of the ice, but you saw Matt Lyle of the Guelph Gryphons make a nice play without taking a penalty, lifting a stick, sticking with a speedy Ray and making a nice play to break up that chance.
You know, Chris Ray is definitely on the radar screen of the Gryphons, and they probably did quite a bit of video work on Ray and his line. Hill lays a body on a man, and the entire Griffin bench jumps up, waiting in for an interference penalty. Now that's Schnurr over the line, but offside will be the call.
Late call. I was hoping he would call that, because that was way offside, and if that created a goal, Griffins would have been even more angry, especially after the non-call, which was a good non-call. He just went after his man and laid the body and hit his man.
I think the Griffins probably were arguing that the puck hadn't been played, but it's one of those judgment calls where the puck is there, so
that's right.
If you don't take the body, the puck would be definitely played and probably played well. It's another one of those gray areas that the officials have to rely on their judgment. Now in on goal, a shot high over the glove. Majera had his man beat to the outside but couldn't find a hole. Clearing attempt, that hit Schnurr right in front of the net, stopped there. Hartigan down to shut down the short side. Bodies flying everywhere. Another penalty coming up to the Warriors. It'll be Keelan Wong, I think. Touches up the puck. Some more fisticuffs after the whistle. Between Zach Lilly and, you're not going to believe this, Aaron Dilio.
No, surprise, surprise. But I think you're right. I think Wong's getting the original penalty for a trip, or...
I think it'll be a trip. Let's see.
I saw him signal that, but...
It is a trip. So, just under 3 minutes into the second period, the Gryphons will go back to the power play. Bray and the speedy Kyle McDonald will be the penalty-killing tandem up front for the Warriors. Whiteley and Cowardine on the point. The Gryphons come with their first power play unit, Kiriakou, and as you mentioned, Chris Bellin parked right in front of the net. Shot was blocked there by McDonald, had a chance to spring Ray, but couldn't find it in his feet. Martin, who we saw play the majority of the power play time for the Gryphons in the first period, also on the ice at the point, quarterbacking the power play for Guelph. Was hammered down and right away, 30 seconds killed off by the Warriors, and the Gryphons haven't even set up in their own zone yet. Kiriakou now streaking down the wing, tries to center that one. Too far for Gale and chipped off the boards and down the ice again by Thomas Cardiff. Fraser is the first one there. Lovrock made a good play. And a late call penalty coming up. Martin is down. That will likely be a hit from behind. The shot stopped by Hartigan. He'll hold. It didn't look like the hand went up until Martin remained down on the ice.
The referee yet to make the signal, but I think you're right. I think he is going to be calling the hit from behind, and Martin lays motionless right now on the ice. And
Cardiff's been ejected.
Cardiff's second hit from behind penalty this year, and when you see the numbers, you gotta slow up, and that's the nature of the game. It's a board. The board's there. It's a dangerous game. I know you wanna lay the man out, but you just gotta realize the numbers are there and let up. And if you don't, that's the result there.
Chris Ray conferring with the official now.
Good to see Martin moving a bit. Sorry there, Adam.
Yeah, no problem. Nathan Martin is still down now. The Warriors training staff is.
And I just read the lips of Ray, five in a game.
Five in a game will be the call. Bit of a scary moment for sure.
I didn't catch it entirely. Did you get a chance to see it clear? Was he turning or was he
already
was turned?
He was turning. It looked to me like Martin had turned to position himself to backhand the puck along the boards and out. Cardiff finished him, didn't catch him squarely from behind.
Yeah, I was looking at the replay, it looks like he caught him on the shoulder, but
did look like he corkscrewed him a little bit into the board, so
yeah, still the number's there, and you just gotta know that it's a hockey play that you gotta slow down for.
Tough to play on that line but not cross it.
That's right.
Martin still being attended to on the ice. And we hope, obviously, that Martin is all right. As you did mention, he was moving a little bit, did roll over from his stomach to his back now.
Don't know if they'll be calling for the stretcher, but he is moving his limbs anyway, and that's a good sign. A big moment in this game, moving back to the game here, where you had a five-minute power play, including a minute, 5-on-3, early in the second period. So we hope for Martin's sake he's okay, and the Gryphons will have a big, big 5-on-3 power play for minute 4, and then they'll have four more minutes on a 5-on-4.
You can see Martin now moving his arms up to his face a little bit. That's another good sign, and moving his legs. Bit of a congregation behind the glass right there. Some concerned looks, and obviously at this point just complete guess, but you wonder with these teams so close together that there's not some friends and family of a lot of these players here. So Martin now sitting up on the ice, maybe more dazed than anything. Not sure.
Yeah, I just don't think he saw Cardiff coming.
Cardiff was coming from behind the net and cycled around, and Martin clearly didn't see him coming, but it was one of those difficult plays where, again, as you mentioned, kind of turned at the last minute, but again, the numbers are there, and the numbers, again, the golden rule, as you mentioned, the numbers are visible, then they're, that's when you need to let up, and clearly Cardiff didn't, and the officials agreed with that.
It's almost as if the official made the call after he saw the result of Martin laying on the ice.
But the hand did go up late, definitely. And
but again, that's what he sees. It's his call to make, and like you said, he's crossed the line on the head. It's a gray area, but judgment call, and the ref made it, and we move on with the game.
So for a minute and 4 seconds, there will be a two-man advantage for the Gryphons. Some ice crew now. It looks like they're...
Looks like some blood to clean up there.
Definitely. Martin was cut, probably on the play. had to guess, probably by his own visor.
Yeah.
Or perhaps one of the stanchions on the glass. Hard to say what kind of injury that was. Obviously, the worry on hits from behind like that is being able to, you know, neck and back injuries and moving extremities. But you wonder now, seeing the cut, maybe a bit more of a concern with a head injury than anything else.
That's right. You don't want to take any chances. And
Martin certainly coming to the bench didn't look as clairvoyant as maybe one should be in an OUA hockey game. So that is the concern. Did skate off on his own power, though. Needed some help, but always good to see a player leave the ice under his own volition. So for a minute four, the Gryphons will have a two-man advantage, and for 5 minutes, a power play. Schnurr, who has, I think, served at least two that I've seen major penalties for game misconducts, will serve this one as well. Not utilized on the penalty kill, so Jarrett Schnurr spends the 5 minutes in the box. Tarmas Cardiff is out of the game. So we're ready to go again with a face-off deep in the Warrior zone to the left of Keaton Hartigan. One there by the Gryphons. Peroff plays catch at the point with Priamo. Tim Priamo works and waits for a shooting lane. Down to Kiriakou, back to Priamo. To Kiriakou, stumbles and falls, back to Priamo. Kicks it ahead to his stick. Peroff fakes a shot. Priamo, his shot. That one was blocked halfway through. Whiteley clears it to the boards, to the line and not out. Peroff keeps it in. Priamo wanted the one-timer, but the pass was in his feet. Kiriakou on the half-boards. Holds and waits. Finds Peroff. Peroff down low, in front of the net. Blocked. Big block by Steve Whiteley. Beautiful passing play, and Gale couldn't finish because Whiteley threw his big body in front.
That's the play they were looking for, the down low and then up into the slot, and you mentioned Whiteley coming out, making a huge block up along the chest.
Gale now, cross-ice pass, tipped away again by Whiteley. Whiteley's active stick and active body, big on the penalty kill, the first power play, over to the line, but not out the puck. 5-on-4 now, chipped ahead, Chris Ray sends it slowly down the length of the ice. Another veteran play by Ray to not fire that down and give the Warriors time to change. 3:43 remaining in the major penalty. Cardiff for checking from behind. Served by Schnurr. Just before the first penalty ended, Hartigan made a good left pad save on another tip. So far, so good for the Warrior penalty kill. Kiriakou hasn't left the ice, nor has Gale. Ed Gale spins back, his pass into Frazier's feet. Frazier, Cowardine to the boards now. Frazier has a chance to clear on the backhand to the line. Not out, kept in there. Now to Peroff. Peroff shot. That one smashed off the boards and out by Molly. Frazier down into the corner and gets a change for the Warriors again. The Gryphons missing their number one power play quarterback defenseman. That play is offside, as Martin was the one that was hit from behind. Doesn't look like they're having problems controlling and setting up the play, but the Warriors doing solid work in the penalty kill. Just over half of the penalty now remains. 2:46 left in the major penalty.
Yeah, good job by Ray in the defensive tandem of Sonnenberg and Whiteley getting in the shooting lanes and just doing a good job of preventing those shots from the point from the Gryphons.
Kept most of the pucks to the outside, and when the Gryphons set up shop, they were able to get sticks in front of passing lanes on cross ice and high slot passes. Now Lyle into the zone. Fakes a shot. Big move. Lyle made a beautiful move there. Now a shot just wide of the net. Lyle undressed Whiteley but couldn't finish. Now he'll cycle it down again to McDonald. On Thomas McDonald to Lyle. Back to Brooke. Barrett Brooke to McDonald. McDonald's wrist shot through traffic, blocked again by Whiteley. And Sonnenberg jumps up. And now the Warriors have a break. Vasey feeds it ahead to Sonnenberg. In alone, shorthanded. Sonnenberg high and wide. Just missed the top corner. Sonnenberg already back to the neutral zone. A huge burst of speed there. Shorthanded breakaway for a defenseman. Now Vasey with a big hit. All the while, Lyland over the line. His shot is wide of the net. Bellin off the bench. Back down to Kiriakou. His pass broken up by Ray, and Ray takes the open wing and plays it down the length of the ice. 1:26 remaining in the Guelph power play.
Not often you see a defenseman on a breakaway. None of them mind on the breakaway, on a shorthanded breakaway. And he was definitely had that glove hand labeled, but shooting it just over the crossbar.
Now another long lead pass for Frazier. Sorry, Dan.
It's all right.
In on goal is Thorner. He tried to shovel it home. Barged his way to the front of the net. Kiriakou now to Priamo. Cross ice pass broken up by Thorner. Off the glass. Thorner can't play it out. Molly has a chance to do it again. He can't do it. Chris Bellin in front. Kiriakou with time. Shot. Just wide of the net. That just dribbled past the far post. Hardigan got just enough of that one. Priamo now. Shot. Pair off. Kicked aside. Up and over the glass and out of play with 34 seconds remaining in the Waterloo penalty. So what was a two-man advantage for a minute and 4 seconds and a full five-minute power play now only has 34 seconds remaining in it, and the score is still 1-0 Gryphons. It looked at the onset that this could be a turning point for the Gryphons. Now if the Warriors can finish this off, it could be a turning point for the home team. Imond. Puck back to the point. Perov can't keep it in. 18 seconds now. Left in the power play. Perov leaves it there. For one last push from the Gryphons. Sharp angle shot stopped. That was Jeff Imond. And Hardigan took it away with 4 seconds remaining now in the power play. Face off to the left of Keaton Hardigan coming up. Hill and Vasey, Howardine and Molly for the Warriors to try to kill the last 4 seconds. Face off, scrambled. Majera back to the line. Campbell's long wrist shot stopped. And the penalty is over. Schnurr is back on the ice. And the Warriors have killed off the five-minute power play. Best chance on that five-minute man advantage was for the Warriors as well on the Sonnenberg breakaway. Shot it just high over the glove side of Andrew Lubrock. Face off again in the Warriors' own. Schnurr taps it to Vasey. Vasey's got a step. Vasey protects to Brook. Vasey in on goal. Poked aside by Lovrock. And a penalty will be called the Gryphons. Brook. Barrett Brook will take the holding call. Vasey went to the outside and protected the puck. So now, immediately after killing off the two-man advantage in the five-minute power play, the Warriors have a chance to even up on the power play. Their first power play since the early stages of the first period. Face-off won by Ray back to Whiteley. To Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg in deep to Moyer. Puck skipped away from him. Kept it alive. Back to Ray. Chip pass Sonnenberg and a two-on-one now. Came on. Short-handed in front. Broken up by Sonnenberg. Cleared aside. Up and over the glass and out of play by the goaltender. Guelph wants to delay a game call on the goaltender, shoveling the puck up over the glass and out of play, but Hardigan didn't even have two hands on his stick. He was clearing the puck aside. Bit of a product of the low glass at the Columbia Icefields, perhaps. Now Ray to Whiteley. Whiteley's pass broken up and cleared the length of the ice by the Gryphons. 1:20 remaining in the Waterloo power play. Sonnenberg, Majera marking him. starts the play, finds Kyle Schwendy. Schwendy brings it in. Lovrock stops that for his defenseman behind the boards. But Whiteley keeps that one in, backhands it across the line to Sonnenberg. In front, Moyer had that one hop off a stick before he could get a shot away. Ray back to the point. Whiteley couldn't keep it in. And Bellin plays it down into the corner, killing off more time. Now Sonnenberg slides away from Bellin, the forecheck. Hard from Chris Bellin, the Guelph captain. Whiteley has to reach for the loose puck up along the glass. On the boards in front of us. Now Whiteley holds and waits in his own zone. Starts off. Finds Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg with speed over the line. Sonnenberg now around the net. Leaves it there for Schnurr. Schnurr looking for a man. Schnurr still holding and watching. Schnurr all the way around in front. Hill couldn't finish that one. Went off the inside of his skate. Hill sets it up, 10 seconds remaining in the power play now. To Whiteley, in front of the net. Schnurr couldn't handle that hot pass, and it's dumped the length of the ice, and that will kill the final seconds of the Guelph penalty. So the Warriors can't capitalize, and the score remains 1-0. Just under 9 minutes now remaining in the second period. And Cowardine, his pass from the wrong side of center, finds nobody, so icing is the call. Certainly an eventful second period, but no scoring so far. Kiriakou's first period goal holding up as the only marker on the scoreboard right now. 8:52 remaining in the second period. It's 1-0 Guelph. Faceoff won by Kiriakou to Gale. Kiriakou, his stick is lifted behind the Warrior net. Molly to the line. Jumped up there was Campbell, I believe, to keep that one in. Excuse me, that was Pelowski. Now to Kiriakou. Kiriakou's shot. Steered aside. Molly tipped that one wide before it reached Keaton Hartigan. Now Schappert, the puck in the feet of Pelowski. Cowardine comes in. Knocks his man clean off the puck. That was Jeffries. And back in the Guelph zone, Friemo. He blew a tire in front of the net. They score! Mike Vasey on the forecheck fed it right in front. And Josh Schappert made no mistake. The game is tied at one. Priamo went into the corner and Vasey's forecheck forced him to blow a tire. He threw it in front of the net and nobody was there except Josh Schappert and a yawning Cage, and he hammered it glove side past Andrew Lovrock. .49 the time of the goal that draws the Warriors even. Should be Schappert from Vasey. But we'll wait for the official scoring. Penalty coming up now to the Warriors. Looks like it'll be a knee or a trip. They finally play the puck. Let's see what the call is. Will be a kneeing call. And it will go to Corey Fraser, I believe. So the Gryphons go back to the power play, 7:42 remaining in the second period. Puck back to Priamo. Priamo shot, tip right on, kicked aside by Hartigan. Gale, in deep, back to the point, it's Priamo. His long wrist shot, stopped. The rebound lies in front of the net. Nobody can reach it. Kiriakou tried. Gale is there, as is Bellin. Kiriakou plays it to Peroff. Peroff, Kiriakou, back to Peroff. Off the end boards a shot. That one was off the side of the net from a sharp angle. In front of the net again, and Chris Ray plays it to the open wing and fetches it himself. feathers it down to the open wing, and Steve Whiteley there to tap it behind the Guelph net. Warriors get a change. Turnover now caused by Lewicki. Aaron Lewicki drives to the front of the net. He couldn't shove it home. Warriors penalty kill. Looking solid right now. Gale, check there by Lewicki, has to circle back into his own zone. Ed Gale now to Tim Priamo. Priamo, I'm sure, looking for redemption after blowing his edge, leading to the Warriors' first goal of the game. That puck hop over the stick there of Ken Paroff, and the Warriors take advantage. Moyer played it back to his own defenseman, Powerdine. Powerdine gave it right back. Campbell winds and fires, stopped, no rebound, held by Keaton Hartigan. Powerdine showing his frustrations after that giveaway in the neutral zone. So faceoff, 24 seconds left now in the power play for the Gryphons. Ray won the faceoff. Whiteley hammers it around the boards. Brook keeps it in, though, at the line. Sends it right back into the corner. McDonald is there. Puck comes to Matt Lyle. Lyle spins it down to McDonald into the corner. Carradine knocked him off the puck. Puck flipped high over the net. Knocked down by Whiteley and cleared the length of the ice. He actually had Chris Ray streaking and maybe could have put together a shorthanded break there. Penalty is over. Barrett Brook in his own zone. McDonald, his pass to Balin. Balin couldn't find that one, and Hill smacks it back in. Schnurr behind the net on the forecheck. Puck given away again. Hill in on goal. In front of the net. Schnurr couldn't tap it home. He had the wide open cage, but he was marked. Campbell took the stick away and saved a goal there for the Gryphons. Another turnover almost caused a Warrior goal. Schnurr throws his man into the boards. Things getting physical once again. Schnurr centers it to Hill. Quick wrist shot knocked down by Lovrock. From the left hand of Lovrock. Smacked that one away. Dilio tries to settle things down behind his own net. Puck almost stolen there on the forecheck. That was Merritt. Now Shepard in on goal. Tries to feed it in front to the trailer Moyer, and it hit a skate before it reached Tyler Moyer. Bouncing puck now, knocked down by Moyer. He'll try to backhand it in front. Shepard is there, as well as Hill. Moyer skates away from it. Now knocked down. Bodies flying everywhere. Shepard. He tries to steal. Did momentarily, but now it's skated away by Zach Lilly. Lilly finds Kinsella. Kinsella's shot going against the grain, high, and just missed the top corner of the blocker side of Keaton Hartigan. Dilio, his pass through the neutral zone. And a penalty has been called. I'm not sure on whom. It's an interference call, and it will go against Mark Pulowski of the Guelph Gryphons. So with 3:58 remaining in the second period, the Warriors will go back to the power play. 1-1 is the score. Once again, my name's Adam McGuire, and we're on the streaming sports network, SSNCanada.ca. The first game of the 2011 portion of the 2010-11 season. Gryphons and the Warriors deadlocked at 1. On the power play, Sonnenberg to Hill. Hill's got some space. Hill waits to set up. Sonnenberg blasts that one off a shin pad into the corner. Hill retrieves it. Kurt Hill on the backhand to Schnurr. Back to Hill. Kicks that ahead. Hill now skates behind the net. Whiteley pinched in for a one-timer. Didn't get it, so he'll retreat back to the blue line. Setting up behind the net is Hill. Hill, Thorner to Schnurr. Schnurr plays it back to the open point. It's Whiteley. Whiteley into Schnurr. In front of the net. Hill down on one knee. Couldn't get the one-timer away. Knocked down by Whiteley out of midair. Good play to keep it in. Sonnenberg across the ice. Schnurr couldn't finish that one off the end boards. And it'll be frozen by Andrew Lovrock. Some good puck movement by the Warriors, but they can't get wood on the one-timers. Twice in that sequence, they had one-time opportunities in good scoring zones and couldn't get a solid shot away. So 1:17 remaining in the power play, 3:15 in the second period. Ray, Moyer, and Schwendi now on. Sonnenberg's one-timer blast off a shin pad. Good block there by Gale, but Sonnenberg keeps it in. Kiriakou was looking for a shorthanded breakaway. Had to come back when he realized Sonnenberg kept the puck in the zone. Ray and Sonnenberg switch places now. Ray in front. Moyer tipped that one just off the side of the net. Moyer now to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg to Whiteley. One-timer steered aside to the boards by Lovrock. Moyer now back to Whiteley at the point. Whiteley's got time. Fans on his pass to Sonnenberg, and the puck will be cleared the length of the ice. Whiteley back to retrieve. 38 seconds left in the power play. Long pass now, chipped in by Schappert. Moyer is there. Spun to the line and out. Jumped over the stick of Schappert, so Carradine is back to get it for the Warriors. 25 seconds left. Time for one more push. Another penalty coming up to the Gryphons. Didn't see it. Would have been behind the play. Campbell plays the puck. It's a slashing call. Don't know on who just yet. It'll be Tim Priamo. So for 16 seconds, the Warriors have a two-man advantage. Certainly, they will look to try to get a quick shot and a chance before the first power play expires. So with 2:14 left in the period, the Warriors will pretty much play this period with the man advantage, unless they score before that. Kept in by Sonnenberg, off the faceoff win by the Gryphons. Kurt Hill now, he's got time. Hill to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg fakes a shot. Checked there by Kiriakou, spins it back. Now to the point, it's Whiteley, and Gale out of the box has a chance on a shorthanded break. Gale in, stopped by Hartigan, the shot, they score! And Gale followed up his own miss with a sharp angle top shelf rebound. And a bad pass back to the point, just as the first penalty expired, leads to a shorthanded goal for the Gryphons. So a bit of bad luck, time with some poor puck movement on the power play. Whiteley had pinched up a little bit for the shot. Missed the pass behind him, and Gale was away to the races. Sonnenberg couldn't get back. Hartigan made a great save on the first attempt, but all the credit in the world to Ed Gale, who from a sharp angle, right off the rebound, stuck it top shelf. Warriors still in the power play, looking for the equalizer now. Schappert, Moyer, and Ray all digging for it behind the net. Ray back to Molly. Molly. Chris Ray on the backhand now to Moyer. Back to Ray. Flips it back. Molly, one-timer shot. Tipped right on. Schappert was in front. But it went right into the equipment of Andrew Lovrock, who holed for a whistle with 1:04 remaining in the power play for the Warriors. They gave an assist to Kiriakou on the goal, so I don't know if he forced a turnover. Some bad luck, definitely, as he cleared the puck, and Gale, all he had to do was stay onside and have a clean break. Schappert back to the point, Whiteley. Long wrist shot, low, steered aside easily by Lovrock. Moyer won the race to the puck, so Whiteley keeps it in at the line to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg to Whiteley. Down to Moyer, Tyler Moyer. Bounce pass off the boards to Schappert. Schappert back to the top of the zone. That's Whiteley. To Sonnenberg, back to Whiteley. On his backhand. That pass Schappert couldn't handle, but Chris Ray has it. To Sonnenberg, quick shot. Stopped by Lovrock and held on. 29 seconds remaining in the power play. 43 seconds remaining in the second period. Guelph leads 2-1 on the heels of the shorthanded goal by Ed Gale. Schnurr against Lilly in the faceoff. Zach Lilly won that, but Warriors retrieve the puck. Schnurr now drags and tries to fire. Whiteley couldn't keep that one into the line, so it's cleared. 16 seconds left now remaining in the power play. Hartigan on the backhand, trying to break it out quick for Whiteley. Zone, stopped an odd man rush there. Thorner was hit hard by Lilly. His arm is A little worse for wear, maybe. Goes to the bench favoring it. 4 seconds left now remaining in the second period. To the line, Campbell keeps it in as the period expires. So after evening the score at one, a late shorthanded marker by Ed Gale has the Gryphons leading after two periods of play, 2-1 Guelph over the Waterloo Warriors. We'll take a break and be back ahead of the third period of play. 2-1, the Gryphons lead the Warriors. Welcome back to the Columbia Icefield on the north campus of the University of Waterloo. Getting set for the third period of play here. After two, the score, the Guelph Gryphons 2, the Waterloo Warriors 1. Goal scorers for the Gryphons, Thomas Kiriakou and Edward Gale. Gale's shorthanded marker coming late in the second period. For the Warriors, the goal scorer is Josh Shepard. Also in the second period of play. Before we get back to this game, however, let's take a trip around the out-of-town scoreboard. The OUA, earlier today, Nipissing beat Ryerson 7-3. Other than that game, this 2-1 score after two is following suit in the OUA with low-scoring tight games thus far. Right now, midway through the third period, McGill and Ottawa are tied at two. Bit of a surprise there, given that McGill hasn't lost in regulation yet this year. RMC ahead of Toronto, 3-2, late stages of the third period, under 8 minutes to play there. After two periods, Lakehead is up on Windsor, up in Thunder Bay, 2-0. Late in the second period, Laurier is in London and losing to the Western Mustangs, 1-0. UOIT is ahead of York, 2-0 after two periods. And again, here our score, the Guelph Gryphons 2, the Waterloo Warriors 1. Shots after two periods of play, Guelph dominating in that category, 29-18. Both goaltenders in this game have been good. We'll see if that trend continues in the third period. Once again, my name is Adam McGuire. With me is Dan Ackerman, and we are on the streaming sports network, ssncanada.ca. Dan, Andrew Loverock and Keaton Hartigan both have been tested at times. Hartigan definitely more so than the two, and even on the second goal for the Guelph Gryphons, the Ed Gale marker, Hartigan made a tremendous save on the breakaway and didn't really have a chance, I wouldn't think. Gale made a tremendous play to stick it far side, top corner, to put the Gryphons ahead 2-1.
Yeah, some sloppy play on the part of the Warriors on that power play to allow that breakaway to happen for Gale. And as you mentioned, Hartigan keeping the Warriors in this game, being outshot 29-18. And it was 16-8 in favor of Guelph in terms of shots in that period. So Waterloo needs to tilt the ice and back in their favor if they're going to even this game up and pull away with a win in this game. But Guelph has looked good defensively and setting up that neutral zone trap. And it's been a story of two hot goalies, and Loverock has played well, Hartigan's played well, and we'll see what happens here in the third. If both teams can stay out of the box, we'll have some good 5-on-5 action.
Absolutely. Things maybe calm down physically a little bit after the injury to Nathan Martin. The hit from behind. Thomas Cardiff was ejected for that one. The Warriors killed off a two-man advantage and had a chance shorthanded, actually, in that one. They had their own two-man advantage, and part of the shorthanded goal was some bad luck, because at the conclusion of the first power play, there was an errant pass back to the point just as Gale was sprung from the box. All he had to do was stay onside and go in for the breakaway. And again, Hartigan made the save, but Gale followed up his own miss with a top-shelf rebound. And that is the difference right now as the third period is underway. And Colin Cowardine for the Warriors settles it down in his own zone. Has Steve Whiteley now. Whiteley, his cross-ice pass to Shepard. Tipped as it went across by Peroff. Loverock set it up behind the net. Now Kiriakou and Vasey. They converge on along the boards. Whiteley finished that check. Shepard had Vasey with him. This line, newly formed, has looked good. Vasey, Shepard, and Lewicki. There's a sharp angle shot there on Keaton Hartigan. He'll stop it and hold the rebound. Hartigan's rebound control, very solid as always, and especially so tonight.
Yeah, that's right. He's done a good job between the pipes, keeping Waterloo in this game for the first 40 minutes, and he looks to do the same here for the last 20.
Difficult, too, for Hartigan. I noticed some new gear for him, and one of the byproducts of that sometimes is the rebound control, and it hasn't seemed to have affected him at all thus far. Campbell, his shot into the corner, dump in, gathered by Kyle Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg had a chance shorthanded on a shorthanded breakaway. Had the top corner labeled and just missed it high. Chris Ray chips it past his man. Can't corral the loose puck, and Brooke turns it back for the Gryphons. Off the boards and out. Sonnenberg retreats into the neutral zone to play it. Slap back in Schwendy, but Lyle intercepted that. Now Lyle over the line. Makes a move. Cuts in front, but he's knocked off stride. Sonnenberg was there, as was Ryan Molly. Now Molly in his own zone. Long lead pass, just missed Chris Ray, and then I'll go for icing. A minute and 30 seconds in to the third period, 2-1, Guelph remains on top.
Well, if you're Brian Burke, you're talking to your boys between periods. You're not pressing the panic button yet. You've got a full 20 minutes, and you're only down by one and getting outshot, so you're in a good position here to get back into this game. It could take a power play, but just take one hard forecheck and one bounce your way, and you're square even at 2-2. So no panic for the Warriors here early in this third period. And if you're the Gryphons, you're looking to keep the pedal to the metal and just keeping the shots at Hartigan and hoping that a couple more get past them to extend that lead.
There's a low-risk shot that Hartigan steered aside. I think the key, as you mentioned, Dan, for the Gryphons is to maintain the aggressiveness on the forecheck. Even on the penalty kill, the Gryphons have been aggressive, sending both forwards chasing after the defensemen for the Warriors when they have the puck, and not just content to let the Warriors move the puck around the perimeter, but really trying to force turnovers even while killing penalties.
That's right.
Kurt Thorner now through the neutral zone, tries to flip it ahead for Kurt Hill. Love Rock out of his net to play that one ahead and start the breakout. Dillio settles it down at center ice. Flips it to Thorner. Thorner steals that from Pulowski and shoots it in himself. Again, Love Rock out to play it. Majera settles it down there, and Zach Lilly makes a move through the neutral zone at center ice. Over the line, a quick shot. That hit Cowardine's stick and ramped up and hit him in the face. He's going to go to the bench. Seems to be no worse for wear. Hill over the line now. Kurt Hill has a step. Wide, his shot through the center crease. Nobody was there. Now a long shot from the point. That was Molly. Nobody could tap that one on net either. Hill's backhand pass. Schappert comes in front. Shot. Stopped. Over the glass and out of play. Lovrock made himself look big, which is easy to do for him.
Yeah, I think Schappert had more time than he knew it, and had the top part of the net open, but as you mentioned, the Gryphon defender did come over and tip it over the glass, and Schappert would like to have that chance back.
And again, Lovrock maybe getting in the head a little bit with his size on a play like that.
Absolutely.
6'4", Andrew Lovrock is one of the larger goalies in the OUA.
You have to get it up in a hurry to get it over Lovrock's shoulders.
Vasey now in on the forecheck. Schappert set a bit of a pick there for Vasey, but the puck turned over, and now a break. It's Michael Cousy. Cousy now behind the Warrior net. Come on, waiting for the pass out front, but it was taken away by Sonnenberg. Vasey to Lewicki. Lewicki tried to step around his man, but it hit a skate. Kinsella got in front of that move, turned the Warriors back in their own zone. Kinsella heavily on the forecheck. Sonnenberg looking to move the puck. Another Warrior with poise when he's got the biscuit is Sonnenberg. Didn't turn it over, but now the Gryphons back in. It's Gale. He tried to cut to the net and had the puck stolen from him. His mates were on a change, didn't have much of an option. So now the Warriors back the other way. Schwendy, he's in on the forecheck. Lovrock looks super confident handling the puck behind his own net. Started the breakout now for Kiriakou. Kiriakou leans on his man, one-handed chance towards the net. Stopped, and two more shots followed up by Bellin that were stopped by Hartigan. He held his ground on the short side. Tremendous play from Kiriakou, who drove to the net and got the one-handed backhander away, even with Moyer leaning all over him. Away with it comes Chris Ray. Ray to Moyer. Moyer's long wrist shot steered aside. Now Ray back to the point. Molly Wrist shot. Ray tipped that one into the crowd of people in front. Molly races to the loose puck. He centers it. Moyer couldn't do anything with it. Off the bench. Now it's Schwendy. He got an elbow in the face. Sorry, that's Schnurr. As the puck goes the other way, Schnurr behind the play. Got an elbow up in the face and no call. Campbell will pick it up. This is Patrick Campbell for the Guelph Gryphons. A wipeout behind the net. Thorner, and he's going to get a penalty. Thorner is going to get a penalty for a trip. Looked like he was trying to come in on the forecheck, lost an edge, and spilled into the feet of the Guelph defender Campbell.
Yeah, I don't know about that call. I don't know if Thorner was coming in for a low check, or if, as you mentioned, if he just lost an edge and took out the Gryphon player, in which case it's incidental contact. And 9 times out of 10, not called for the trip. So difficult call to swallow there for Burke and his Warriors, but they'll have to prevail and get a big kill here and gain some momentum from it.
Even Keaton Harding, the goaltender, talking things over with the official now.
Yeah, saying, what kind of call was that?
Bit of a zero-tolerance call, but in fairness, the game has been called close to the vest all night, so it's not a surprise necessarily. Off the face-off, the puck was cleared. Lewicki and Frazier, the forward tandem, killing this penalty for the Warriors. Just past the five-minute mark in the third period, the Gryphons lead 2-1, and they look to expand their lead. On the power play now, Lyle back to Peroff. Shot from McDonald. That one hit some bodies in front. At least one, and deflected over the glass and out of play.
Well, you hate to speak too soon, but it does seem as if cooler heads have prevailed since that first period, and the talk that the refs had with the coaches seems to have got through to the players, and they've cleaned their act up, and they've stuck to the game of hockey, and we've seen a pretty good game here at the Columbia Icefield.
Turning point two may have been the hit from behind that looked like a serious injury to Nathan Martin. He was able to get to the bench on his own volition. Ray, shorthanded now, pinned up against the boards, but was able to advance the puck to McDonald. McDonald and Ray both. Paradine pinches up dangerously, shot on net. Warriors had three men in relatively deep spot, shorthanded. Now a shot right on Hartigan. It popped up and he caught it to eliminate the rebound with 1:03 remaining in the Guelph power play.
A dangerous play by Cardine to step up there in a shorthanded situation and fire the shot on net, but got a chance out of it, and that's a good try by Cardine and Ray going to the net. But Love Rock steered aside, and Gryphons will have the power play remaining for 1:03 here.
Face off in the feet. Comes to Priamo. Not a Brook. He hammered that one wide. Priamo will keep it in, though. To Kiriakou. Back to Tim Priamo. Tim Priamo sidesteps. Backhand pass off of Corey Frazier's skate. And back into the Gryphon zone. Long pass from Barrett Brook to Kiriakou. Kiriakou gains the line. Bounce pass behind the net. Comes to Gale. Gale to Bellin. Back to Gale. Ed Gale. Out of the corner, had some room, didn't shoot. Priamo's shot now. Blocked there. Frazier threw the hand out. That stung him, but it was a solid play to block that shot. Throwing a glove hand out like a goaltender. Dump in deep. Bounced off the boards where the board and the glass meet, right to the front of the net, and it's frozen there by Keaton Hartigan. 2 seconds remaining now in the power play. 12:50 in the third period. Still 2-1 Guelph. Dan, the Guelph power play looks a little bit disjointed without the quarterback Martin back there.
Yeah, absolutely. You mentioned that the first 40 minutes when he was on the ice, he controlled that play and controlled the back end of that power play.
Pulowski steps into one off the glove and just over the net. A rolling puck, and Hartigan got just enough of it. Close call there for the Warriors. Keelan Wong leans on his man. That's James Merritt. Merritt spun into the ice now. Long tries to fetch the puck. And a penalty now coming to the Gryphons. Penalty will go to James Merritt. It's going to be a slash. In his battle with Keelan Wong, he'll protest the call, but to no avail. So the Warriors now have a chance to even things up on the power play with 12:19 remaining in the third period.
Yeah, just what the doctor ordered. They definitely needed this power play to get the momentum back in this period after a Gryphon power play that was disorganized, and Waterloo hopes that they can get their exit out of their end zone and get a clean entry into the Gryphon zone and set it up and see what kind of looks they can get. And I'm sure they'll be looking for the Whiteley or Sonnenberg one-timer from the back end.
Face-off in the neutral zone.
Not sure why. Oh, because it was called on the offside. That's right. I believe the offside was for the whistle.
It was, I believe it was an icing call, actually, for the
ref. Yes.
Referee and linesman conferring now, so it was an icing call, but as per the rule, the face-off should be in the Guelph zone, but it's going to stay where it is.
Not sure about that, but we'll move on and we'll find out later.
Perhaps a rule that neither of us know about with when a puck is iced on a delayed penalty.
Yeah, that's true.
Moyer played that on the offside, and they're calling it intentional offside, so it'll come all the way down to the Warriors' zone. Bit of a careless play by Moyer. Had to know the play was offside.
Ref telling the Guelph player he's going to sit longer if he doesn't shut up. So he's done a good job of controlling this game. It could have been messy by about now, but he's done a good job of taking hold of this game and letting these guys make sure they have a safe game out there.
Turnover in the neutral zone. Now a 2-on-2 for Guelph shorthanded. Majera winds and fires. He dragged that, toe-dragged it, and looked like he was going to cut to the center of the ice, but shot back to the short side, and Hartigan was there. Tough to fool a goaltender of Keaton Hartigan's acumen with a shot like that. Face off, won by the Gryphons, kept in. Schappert knocked that one down, and Chris Ray is away with Moyer. Back to Ray in front. He just missed tipping that one on goal. Whiteley down to Ray. 1:15 remaining in the power play now. Ray to the corner. Priemo stopped that one. Whiteley kicks it soccer style and keeps it in the zone. Went to Sonnenberg. In front, Ray tipped it just wide of the net. Chases his own rebound off the end boards. Ray now to Whiteley. Whiteley skates to find a lane, tipped, but not towards the net. Schappert lost the stick. Ray now with it behind the net. Off the boards, bounce pass to Sonnenberg to Whiteley. Whiteley shot. That one was blocked on the way through and cleared the length of the ice. Kiriakou got a stick in front of that one. Whiteley cranking up through the neutral zone. Had the puck knocked off his stick, so Sonnenberg will settle it down and wait for his defensive partner to regain his position on the ice. Jarek Schnurr now. Schnurr shoots it in wide of the net, fetches his own rebound to Hill. Hill across the ice. Sonnenberg winds and fires, stopped. Whiteley on the rebound to Hill in front of the net. Schappert, he can't handle that one, and it's cleared with 7 seconds remaining. That will kill the remainder of the Waterloo power play. Couple of close calls and some decent shots towards the net, but they were easily handled by Lovrock. Now a low wrist shot. That one was wide. The other way, this is McDonald. McDonald couldn't reach the loose puck. Cut off there by Cowardine. Schnurr was bothered by Bellin, but the play is offside. So 1 second short of the midway point of the third period, the score remains 2-1 Guelph.
A couple good opportunities, as you mentioned, on that power play. Coming in late in that power play was the Sonnenberg shot from the point. No one there for the rebound, though, and Lovrock did a good job of controlling that rebound off his right pad and shoveling it to the right corner to elude that chance for the Warriors.
Now Kiriakou off the end boards, tried to find Gale on the nifty bounce pass, couldn't do it. Pulowski hammers it right back in. Warriors have a chance to set up. Now Guelph going to a passive forecheck. Everybody standing still. It's the 1-2-2 forecheck. Maybe nursing the lead. Could be a little bit of a dangerous premise if the Warriors get their feet moving and get speed through the neutral zone. Long pass. Icing waved off. Lewicki and Vasey in on the forecheck. Schappert there too. Schappert pinned up against the boards by Pulowski. Priemo, his shot off a stanchion, comes right to the point. That's Molly. He keeps that one in. Knocked down and shoveled the length of the ice by Priemo. Back into the Warriors' zone. Colin Cowardine gathers it for the hometown Warriors. Priemo now. His pass intercepted by Cowardine. Couldn't jump up into the zone. Play would have been offside, so he had to wait. Schappert tried to tip that one one-handed past Vasey. Now Vasey tried to shovel that one in for Schappert. Couldn't do it. A little bit of a game of ping pong in the neutral zone right now. Puck going from blue line to blue line. Long pass for a streaking Chris Ray. Ryan Molly apoplectic at himself on that play. Had Ray streaking and the pass was way too high and far. And he knew it as soon as he shoveled the puck.
Yeah, tough one to handle for Ray. The Warriors are just going to have to start getting some puck towards the net. They're trying to get too pretty in the neutral zone. Just get it over the center line, dump it in, get a chase on, and hope for some good cycling and a chance on net and see what happens.
That is how they manufactured their first goal, with the solid forecheck, forcing a turnover, and just a quick shot. Wasn't the prettiest of plays, but certainly works.
And Guelph doing a great job keeping the puck out of their zone and having that 1-2-2, and as they go to the penalty here on a tripping call.
Whiteley was spilled. Penalty will likely be to John Thomas McDonald. He knows it too. That one was a no-doubter.
Yeah, definitely an obvious tripping penalty for McDonald. And the Warriors will get their second chance on the power play in this third period to equalize this game at two. With 8:05 remaining in the third period, we'll get two or less on this power play chance.
Ray to face off. Won the face off back to Whiteley. Whiteley to the half boards. That's Moyer playing catch with Ray. Ray to Whiteley, looking for a shooting lane. Ray now drops it for Whiteley. Back to Ray. Ray's quick shot. The rebound is in front. Clear to the sideboards, but not out. Moyer knocked off his feet by Merritt. Some good work by Merritt. James Merritt on the penalty kill knocks that one back into the Warriors' zone, where Whiteley and Sonnenberg settle it down for Waterloo. Sonnenberg to Ray. The pass beyond him. Ray will gather it at the blue line, but can't advance it again offside. So we'll play it back for Schappert. Puck left there for Whiteley. Whiteley, his wrist shot. Bounces back down to Ray off the deflection. He couldn't get wood on it. Sonnenberg now fires. That shot is blocked. Matt Lyle sprawling. That one stung. But it was a good shot block nonetheless from Lyle. Schappert tried to one-touch that one in on the dump-in. Couldn't do it. Now a long cross-ice pass. Ray touches it back to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg over the line. Still with the puck. Finally stolen. Whiteley couldn't keep it in. And now Kiriakou's got a break. Kiriakou with only Ray back. Kiriakou. Ray made a great play. Got the puck first. No penalty. Chris Ray on the back check. Made a tremendous diving play. The Gryphons bench doesn't agree with it. Now in front. Schnurr tried to center it for a streaking corner. Schnurr. Molly in on the pinch. Not clearing attempt with 20 seconds remaining in the power play. Will flutter down to Keaton Hartigan. Another shorthanded chance. We've seen a few of them tonight.
Yeah,
and
Ray,
one shorthanded goal. Sorry, Dan.
That's all right. Good job of Ray getting back there on the power play for a minute 30. And still having some energy left to get back and spoil that Griffin breakaway on the shorthanded chance.
Molly now and another break chance now for McDonald out of the box. Cowardine's going to get there first, but a 2-on-1 develops in front of the net. Shoveled just wide. That was Gale streaking to the net, making it a 2-on-1, but it was wide of the net. Cowardine played that one deep into the corner, shot over the glass and out of play on the clearing attempt by Mark Pulowski of Guelph.
Well, The power play looked good in the early going, and then it just kind of fell apart there. They seemed to get disorganized, but they did have some good opportunities in the first minute of that power play, but Love Rock spoiled those chances and made a big right pad save on Ray early on.
Now the Griffins back to full strength. It's McDonald flips it in and chases it himself. Hardigan out to play it on the backhand all the way around, but jumping up there first is Brooke. Now the puck flipped back into the neutral zone. It's loose, and Corey Frazier will try to look for a steal. Can't find one. Puck turned back over. It's Sonnenberg. Backs into his own zone. Plays it across to Dilio. Dilio to Lewicki. He chips it in, and Vasey goes in on the forecheck on Pulowski. Vasey, whose forecheck caused the first goal, led to the turnover, and he centered it in front of the net. Turned back over. It's Matt Lyle. He's got some speed on the wing. Matt Lyle shot off the side of the net. Big hit behind the net. Vasey. It's going to be a penalty to Guelph. Didn't see it. It's going to be a high stick.
Was that from the hit? I guess he got hit and then came through with the high stick. I'm not exactly sure.
It's got to be the call because it had the arm went up at the hit.
That's right.
It's Cale Jeffries. It's not going to be Jeffries. It's McDonald going back to the box.
The hell's that for insult injury? You get hammered and you're going to the box. I don't know if I agree with that call. I mean, someone who's getting hit, he has no control of a stick, and if it comes down and hits the opposition player in the face or wherever, it's not a call you normally see made by an official.
Unless it was a behind the play, I didn't see it, but again, you're right. If it was on the hit, it's a difficult call to make. Again, another one of those zero tolerance calls that by the book is what should be called, but difficult to actually call in the middle of a game like this.
Not a call Sean Kemp is liking right now, that's for sure.
In front, off the side of the net. Shepard had a chance there. The puck cleared past Ryan Molly. Tyler Moyer had a shot. Centered it in front, and Shepard just tapped it off the side of the net. Warriors now moving slowly and methodically out of their own zone. Chris Ray has Whiteley. Whiteley now. Moyer settles it down at the point. Sonnenberg fakes a shot to Whiteley. His shot tipped off of Paroff and up and over the net. Blocker side. Didn't miss by much. Moyer knocks that puck down. Can't reach it. And it's dumped around to Lilly. To the line and out. Sonnenberg couldn't keep it in. Merritt gave him a shot as he skated by. Now Kyle Sonnenberg. Up off the boards and cleared right away again. Turned over, and it's Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg beats Paroff. Didn't beat him, actually. Had the puck knocked off of him. A good active stick by Paroff. Now it's Whiteley. His pass to Schnurr. Schnurr was coming back to the puck and couldn't slap it in. 19 seconds now remaining in the Waterloo power play.
Not a smart pass by Whiteley there. Just to give it to the man streaking up and gain the zone the easy way.
Hill had a step, but a good defensive play by Patrick Campbell. Knocked that puck away. Now Whiteley with 6 seconds left. Sets up Sonnenberg's shot. That one was stopped. Thorner was in front on the doorstep. Thorner and Schnurr, the penalty over. Pass back to Whiteley. Over to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg spins away from Macek. Sonnenberg to Whiteley. Whiteley holds and waits. Shot, but it's blocked. Big shot block sliding across. It was Alex Majera who got his feet on that one. Up and over the glass and out of play.
Yeah, good job on Majera coming across, and can't believe Sonnenberg even found Whiteley. He was facing the boards and somehow found Whiteley looking through the back of his helmet, and Whiteley took a little too long with that chance, and Majera came across and made a big block on the shin pads. Well, the Warriors have had their chances to even up with three power play opportunities, but they've all been spoiled by the Griffins' excellent penalty killing.
Face-off won there by the Griffins, but Lewicki pins it up against the boards and keeps it in. 2:30 now remaining in this third period. 2-1. game will come down to the wire as we expected. Howard on to Molly. Molly's pass was fanned on. Turned back over, and Guelph content to just slap it back in the Warrior zone. Cowardine sets up the breakout there with Lewicki. Back to Cowardine, to Molly. Molly backhands it into the corner. Fraser is the first one there on the forecheck on pair off. Lewicki follows up with a hit on him. Molly with a pinch, maybe ill-advised. Now Vasey back in a defensive role. Cowardine takes a shot, knocked Gale off his feet, and now a mix-up in front of the net, and Hardigan is into it. So much for cooler heads prevailing. Hardigan and Majera exchanging words. Lewicki is down with Kiriakou into the corner. And Gale is shoved away, paired off with Cowardine. Keaton Hardigan, a soft-spoken, intelligent place for sure, and certainly competitive as anybody else. Looks like it'll be offsetting penalties, four in total, two for each club. Officials now exchanging words with Sean Camp.
Sean Camp playing the power play game, saying we've been short the last three times. When's our opportunity? And I guess the ref just doesn't want to decide this game, and he'll probably leave it 5-on-5 and let the players sort it out at the last minute 44 remaining in this game with the Gryphons up 2-1.
I didn't see. I wonder if after the stop, Hardigan got a high stick up on around his mask.
Yeah.
I didn't see what happened, but certainly Hardigan took exception to something and was adjusting his facial gear after that. So I'm wondering if that's maybe what had happened. All told, though, it does look like it'll probably be offsetting penalties with 1:44 left. Warrior head coach Brian Burke right at the gate trying to figure out what the penalties are against his club. A little more calm than Sean Camp right now. And again, Camp's point, as you mentioned, Dan, was the Warriors have had the last three power play opportunities.
Chatting with the refs to figure out.
We'll have to await the calls. I didn't see. I think Lewicki and Kiriakou for sure are in the box for the Warriors and the Gryphons.
Carradine.
Respectively. Carradine's in there as well. I can't see who the second Gryphon is. So as far as the game situation goes, it's much ado about nothing.
That's right. We're marine 5-on-5 for the final minute and 44 here.
Chris Ray's stick explodes on the faceoff, but he did win it. It'll be a testament to the strength of Ray on the faceoff. Sonnenberg sidesteps one man and now a second. Puck knocked away, though, and it's Lilly. In on goal, a shot stopped by Hardigan. We'll watch for Hardigan now, under a minute and 25 seconds now left in this game. We'll watch for when Hardigan goes to the bench for the extra attacker. Ray chipped it by a man and Friemu. Friemu spins. Kept in at the line by Whiteley. A leaping Steve Whiteley kept that one in. Kept it in again, but Merritt will clear. Tremendous effort by the 6'5 Whiteley. Kept it in, but only momentarily. Puck left behind the net. Got mixed up with the broken stick. Sonnenberg careful to play that one, pick it out of this stick. Head to Ray. Ray drops that one back to Moyer. Maybe a little too fancy. Goaltender was heading to the bench. Hardigan had to peel back. Whiteley shakes off his man. Lyle tried to steal it. Now Whiteley to Sonnenberg. 36 seconds remaining now in the third period. Sonnenberg to Whiteley. Here comes the goaltender Hartigan for the extra attacker. Chris Ray through the neutral zone. Ray to the corner. Schaffert. Hill is the extra man off the bench. Ray back to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg keeps the bouncing puck in. Shoots it off of Ray to the loose boards. And cleared the length of the ice with 13 seconds left. Sonnenberg, the puck on end. No icing. Shot the length of the ice. That will be icing with 4 seconds left. And for all intents and purposes, that will be the game. Warriors bench wondering where the icing call was on the rolling puck. Where Sonnenberg, who's been on the ice certainly for this last minute and 45 seconds.
Yeah, the Warriors just unable to gain a clean entry there. Two pretty plays in the neutral zone. They just need to get it in, chip it in, and put pucks on net and drive the net, and they were just being too cute in the neutral zone, and it cost them.
So Chris Ray lost that faceoff. That will end his point streak as well. And the Guelph Gryphons will skate out of the University of Waterloo's Columbia Icefield with a 2-1 victory. A late second period shorthanded goal by Ed Gale was the difference. And in what was a chippy affair, the Warriors had lots of chances on the man advantage and couldn't cash in.
Yeah, they certainly had their opportunities to get back in this game. The refs giving them a couple of favorable calls, and they were unable to capitalize and give all the credit in the world to the Guelph Gryphons. They came out here and played a fantastic road game and took the crowd out of it early, and it was a physical game, and they were able to capitalize on their chances. Hartigan kept the Warriors in this game, but they did get two past them, and that second one on the short-handed goal stands up as the winner as they skate away with the 2 points, and the Warriors will have to sort it out tomorrow as they travel to Toronto to face the York Lions for a rare Sunday evening game.
Absolutely, Dan. The Warriors, if I'm head coach Brian Burke, I'm probably not too happy with the effort of the Warriors. Obviously, the final shot tally not quite in yet, but early on, the shots, especially even through the second period, shots were 29-16 for the Guelph Gryphons. So again, as you mentioned, a solid road game for them. And we'll be back as the Warriors travel on the road tomorrow. They'll be back home next weekend.